Hi, I'm Mitch Shoemaker, and today is day 64 of my doing 100 days of YouTube videos and focusing on my writing. So, yay for day 64, I think. I know this video was like really late because I just haven't gone to bed yet. So, I'm still counting it for day 64. Just having one of those nights where I just want to go to bed and I don't want to write and I don't want to do a video. So I'm playing my little avoidance game, and the longer I avoid things, the later I stay awake and the longer things don't get done. So I don't know what is going on with me right now. I think I'm just really tired. I'm having this I did a little bit of writing. I basically typed up, opened the blank document on my laptop and just typed avoidance for the title and just typed up all my things that I'm avoiding, why I feel like I'm avoiding things. And then I kind of got down to the bottom, and I like the Disney movie The Little Mermaid. That is like was my favorite Disney movie growing up. I remember watching that tons of times at my friend's house because we didn't actually own it, or we didn't have a TV to watch something. I don't remember which, but anyway, loved that movie. And so I was doing my writing, and I realized that I kind of feel like Ariel, the Little Mermaid, and I'm trapped under the ocean floor, and I can hear Sebastian singing that song about how great it is on the ocean floor and all the things you have and all the animals that sing and how you're free and how it's everything looks better somewhere else, but you're actually better where you're at. That whole song, I can't remember all of it other than life is better here. Take it from me, under the sea song. Been too long since I've seen that movie. I'm sure if I heard the song, I could sing along. But anyway, thinking about that and how things in my life are good. They're just not necessarily going quite the way that I want, but they're working, and I just need to continue doing what I'm doing, and I will eventually get to where I want to be. But I think I'm more like Ariel, and I have my little collection of things, and I want to be part of a different world. I see what other people have. I see the palace, the land, the people that walk around, the dance, walk down the street, and I'm stuck underwater. Or maybe it's vice versa, but that was the analogy that came to my brain when I was typing up. And I think sometimes I get so focused on where I want to be, what my end goal is. And it's good to have something to look forward to and to want to be, but I think sometimes I just get frustrated at how long it takes to get there. And then I feel at some point I just feel like it becomes impossible. I get somewhere in the middle, maybe halfway there, and I start feeling like it's impossible. And I think because I'm just behind on all the Christmas stuff, because I haven't actually worked a whole lot on any of my books for like the couple of weeks. I've just been doing other random things. And not that I haven't been writing, not that I haven't been learning or discovering things about myself, because I've done all of that in my writing. And I've still made my videos every single day. So it's been good, and it's been a good experience, and it's something that I want to continue to do because I do eventually want to finish my books. It's just coming to the point realizing that I avoid things because it means I have to face my feelings, I have to face my emotions, and realizing that sometimes my emotions are very irrational, very unrealistic, and that sometimes it's just a matter of perspective, and my perspective gets distorted very easily. And oftentimes I look at where I want to be, and then I look at where I'm at, and I do this comparison thing, and I'm nowhere near where I want to be. And maybe I'm closer to where I want to be than I realize, or maybe I'm further away than I want to be, and I just get disappointed, I get discouraged, and I let those feelings take control. And sometimes I don't realize that's what I'm doing. And so like tonight I was doing my writing, and I'm like, been home, I'd been up for a couple of hours, and I got all these things to do. All I wanted to do was go to bed and go to sleep. And I just couldn't come up with an excuse to not do my video tonight. Couldn't come up with an excuse to not try to write something. So then I just stayed awake because I can't go to sleep if I don't do this, because I know I won't sleep if I don't do this. But then I just didn't want to do this. So then, like I said, I typed up all the things that I'm avoiding, and it turned into all the feelings of being overwhelmed and feeling like I have to do all or nothing, and realizing that I'm like Ariel and fantasizing about living on land, and I'm stuck underwater. And underwater is beautiful. It's gorgeous. It has everything that I could possibly need, everything that I could possibly want. And I want some fresh air. Like, I want to go to the surface. I want some fresh air. I want my books to be published. I want to be able to stay at home and get paid to write. I want to have residual income coming in. I don't want to have to stress about money. I don't want to have to stick to a schedule. I want to just feel like I'm free as a bird, and instead of having to constantly swim, constantly stress, constantly having to work. But I know that if I'm free as a bird, supposedly, and feel like I, no chains, no responsibility, no all of that, that I get bored or I get depressed because I have nothing to do, and those aren't good things either. So it's somehow finding a balance. And I think I do come up for air a few times, which is why I see all the pretty things on land, and I want all the pretty things on land, and I live underwater. And that's kind of, and maybe someday, but I also did write that I'm like, I'm smart enough not to go to the sea witch to ask for help. I'm not gonna do that and get caught in some trap, although sometimes it feels like that. With my finances and things, like, how did I get there? Trying to get out of there. Gotta get rescued. Gotta rescue myself because nobody's coming to the rescue. There's no King Triton with his magic trident or whatever that's gonna fix everything. So, yeah. No Prince Eric is gonna come and rescue me or try to and nearly get drowned in the process. But so, anyway, I don't have any of that in my life. But I do have friends, and I do have family, and I do have God. I do have a savior. I have all of these other things that I'm very grateful for, that I'm very aware of. I'm very aware of all the miracles in my life, and I'm very grateful for all of these awarenesses, because it doesn't matter how much I want to complain or how much I want to give up. I remember that God is rooting for me, and he's not going to give up on me. That I have friends that are rooting for me, and family, and my bishop, and church members, and just whoever's watching these videos, probably, hopefully, rooting for me. And there's that part of me that just really wants to succeed, that wants to see what happens, to see where I end up, to see where things are gonna go, and to know that if I push forward, if I push through this, that I will feel better, that I will get out of this slump that I'm in, that I will begin to appreciate the water that I'm around, that I will begin to maybe enjoy taking some breaths or laying on the sand for a little bit before I have to dive back into the water, that I might eventually find a balance and a schedule. And I think I just get frustrated with myself because I can't seem to do it overnight. I get caught in that, has to be all or nothing. And if I can't do it all, then I can't do anything. And I think that's kind of where I'm at, where I'm feeling like I can't do it all. I can't do all the things that I wanted to do right now. And so then that feeling of that means I can't do anything or I failed is kicking in. And I know that's not the right answer. I know I just can't do it all at once. It doesn't mean I can't eventually get it all done, and it's all just going to take longer than I want it to, but it doesn't mean that I have to give up. It doesn't mean stop or quit. This is a learning thing. This is a lesson. This is a realizing that things happen one day at a time. This is a, I don't have to do it all at once. I don't have to feel overwhelmed. I don't have to feel disappointed or discouraged. I can just be happy in the moment and do the best that I can and be grateful for the little miracles and the little blessings that are happening in my life. And so I'm grateful I know those things. It's just internalizing all of that. And like I said, sometimes those negative thoughts, that feeling of overwhelm or feeling like I failed or I can't, it just takes over. And I don't know where it comes from. And it's like, I'm having a good day, everything is fine. And then suddenly I just don't want to do anything anymore. And it's like, what am I doing? What am I missing? And maybe it's because I haven't written in my journal for a few days. Maybe it's because I didn't read my scriptures and meditationals today. It's amazing the difference those little things in my day make in my attitude and my ability to function on a day-to-day basis. And it's hard. And maybe it's because my to-do list is a mile long and I'm only capable of going a quarter of a mile per day. So I need to shrink my to-do list. I need to let go of my unrealistic expectations because I can't meet those expectations, at least not on a daily basis. And as long as those are my expectations, as long as my expectations are unrealistic, I will always be disappointing myself. And I don't need to disappoint myself. I need to be gentle and loving with myself. And I know yesterday it was kind of nice. When I did read my scriptures and meditationals and I went to do my writing, I asked myself those questions. What can I do for myself today? What do I need today? What? And I did those things. And maybe I didn't get everything on my to-do list today, but instead of making it a to-do list, I said, what would I like to accomplish today? So it was like, what would I like to accomplish today? Now, what am I going to accomplish for the day? What would I like to accomplish for the day? And I didn't accomplish everything on the list, but it was a much gentler way to make a to-do list, and I didn't do that today. Maybe I need to do that. So I don't know. Maybe I just know that I need to face my emotions and I need to do some crying and just let go of some things. And I just need to let myself breathe, and I need to let myself sleep, and I need to take better care of myself. And just feeling like I need to take better care of myself. I need to eat healthier. I need to exercise. Feels like adding more stuff to my day that I already struggled to do in the first place. And then I feel overwhelmed and I just don't want to. So tonight was my I just don't want to. And I'm doing it anyway. So that's why my video is really late. But at least I'm doing it. At least I did it. At least I know that I can do this. And I am grateful for that. And hopefully tomorrow will be a little bit better. And I think that's all that I have today. But at least I wrote something and at least I made my video. So yay! 36 more days to go. Yay! Okay, that's all I have. If you like, you can hit like, subscribe, share if you want to or not. It's up to you. And I hope you have a great day full of gratitude and maybe do some writing.